Northport with the basketball, holding a two-point lead over the Beale City Aggies in what has been just an absolutely sensational Class D state championship game.
It's been a good one, hasn't it?
That it has. Oh, Beale by Pong. And now Beale City with a chance to tie it up or even possibly take a lead with a three-pointer. Schaefer tries to take that lead. Rebound that time. Joshua Race with the board. Stowe kicks it out. Thomas. Corson. Corson on the baseline. Now picking the foul before the shot. I see
him. He's third real quick. You see, the problem that Northport faces, Rick, is Beale City lost Jason Gottlieb, who's their best shooter. Northport lost Sanders Scott, who's their best shooter, but he's also the best basketball player. They lost a little bit of control on the floor. I think that's that might be a little challenge to overcome, but they do have a one-point advantage.
First time at the lobby. Doesn't get it. Big rebound inside. Keep it. 1:45 to go.
Northport could play for the good shot. Show some patience. It would help their cause tremendously.
Thomas.
That is not the good shot.
Well, you can see, though, they're not used to playing this
way. No, they're not. Yes, you're absolutely correct.
Thomas. Out on the top. Race back out to Jason Stowe. And a timeout call with 1:23 to go in the game. We'll keep it right here and analyze this, but we mentioned, Ed, that, you know, when you play the kind of basketball, it's so opposed to what you're used to doing when you're used to race basketball.
Like being a drag strip racer, and all of a sudden you got to run in a, a 5,000-mile race, and you got to play it totally differently. And these guys are used to racing up and down or making two passes at the most and throwing at the hole. Really control himself down.
Well, we talked about Sanders Scott being a junior, but Northport was starting three juniors and one of their top subs off the bench with, as a junior, including Sanders Scott coming back there. Well, they could make a nice turn and run again next year.
If you know how tough that tournament road is, the mean little things get in your way, and all of a sudden people who aren't supposed to win do win. And Dundee upsetting
DeForest
down to the Detroit area. That was a major shot. And then Dundee just knocked off the next game.
That's the beauty of the state tournament here.
Right. We have two champions already crowned today. Class D, Grand Rapids South District this morning beat Bishop Forge 69-66. An absolutely great basketball game. And this afternoon, Detroit truly defended its title in Class A, defeating Fort Northwestern 66-55. And right now, Northport sitting on a two-point lead over Beale City with 1:23 to go in the final period, 76-74.
Thomas on the left side to Stowe.
At Thomas for the second underneath.
Thomas lost it but got it back.
He's tough.
Near steal by Pong. Jason Stowe to Thomas.
That's right, don't shoot it. About a minute.
Thomas is fouled out front. Schaefer or Fox.
It might be blocked, but let's see. Nope.
First foul on Todd Schaefer. At the line for the 1-1, Fred Thomas. He's 0-for-1 so far tonight from the charity strike. 75% free throw shooter on the year.
He is kind of the inspirational leader.
Puts his team on top by three with 1:03 to go in the fourth quarter.
The vital point.
Especially against a team that can shoot triples. He has 12 for the game. Northport brings it back.
Now, Beale City has a few more weapons offensively than Northport does. Let's see what they do.
Schaefer fakes, almost draws the foul. Pung all the way inside, scoops it up nicely. Pung with a big quarter, 5 in the quarter, 10 two-point lead for Gulfport as they bring it up. 40 seconds to go. Thomas on the right side.
Gulfport does not have to shoot. They'll shoot that one.
It's blocked. Followed up and blocked again. And a tie-up will give it back to Beale City.
Oh. That is the 15-point goal right there.
Timeout. 26 seconds to go in the game.
And we can get a replay of that.
Let's watch it again. Gulfport on top by two, but Beale City now has the ball after this flurry.
Ball underneath. Gulfport puts it up. Again, I think there could have been a call there. I'll put the shot on the left arm.
All right, just 26 seconds to go. And Beale City will have the basketball. Trailing by two.
All right, now. Your Beale City coach, Tom Lavoie. You're down by two with 26 seconds to go. What do you do? Try for two to go for die. You try for three to win it all.
If Sandra Scott was still in the game, I think I'd try for three, but he's not, and I would like my chances in overtime, you know, without Sandra Scott. That's what I'd be thinking if I were Tom Lavoie over on the Beale City side.
I agree with you. I think he was around trying to get the two points. I think you get it whenever you can, and I hope you play defense the other end because Sandra Scott is not in the ballgame. Token pressure now from Gulfport.
Fred Thomas, though, will stay with Matt Fox all the way up. Here comes Schaefer. Schaefer all the way to the hole. Nice score. He's tied it up with 15 seconds to go. And Gulfport now calls a timeout. Now we're talking strategy there. Todd Schaefer just cut the ball underneath his arm. Landed the number three holes to try and stop me.
That's right. And if you get the basket, then you can maybe force them because they don't have Scott. They being Gulfport don't have Scott available. Best offensive weapon is one. Here's the move right here. Great move. Oh, nice effort.
Well, I tell you, that's a nice move under any circumstances, yes. But to make that with a team down by two in the remaining seconds of the fourth quarter, they were 21 points. Lead Beale City.
But we have played 51 minutes and 44 seconds, and we are right where we began. All tied up.
78-70.
Gulfport.
Last D title game. A lot of folks at home have a tendency to, in this situation, say, well, hey, what's the problem for Gulfport? You play for the last shot? The worst you can do is overtime. Playing for the last shot and protecting the ball is not nearly as easy as it might seem to some folks at home.
Gulfport is probably more concerned with making sure they get a good shot.
Beale City's going to make them work for it.
Yes, they are.
They're going to show a little press. Be listening to see if they go long on this.
Man on man, probably.
And now they drop back to it. All right, here we go. Jason Stowe. They'll want Thomas to take it with seven. On the left side, Daniel Stowe. Got it! Timeout! With 2 seconds to go.
Good move. Cradles the ball. And it's the shooter's ball.
That was one tough shot. He's saying.